There was really not many thoughts about whether or not to go or not. I mean, obviously, Sierra Leone was special to me. I did have the training and felt I should go. And also, I think probably very importantly, which you often don't think of, I have a very supportive family. I have a big family and lots of grandchildren, and they kind of were saying to each other, well, when have you heard from Mom yet? Have you heard from Mom yet? Because they knew that I would be going. It was just a matter of when. The children make a tremendous impact on you. I'm a grandmother, and I would look at these little children, and I would think, they're so alone here, and so many times they'd already lost their parent, or perhaps their parent was in the next bed with them and not doing well, not well enough to care for them. We had a little baby. Her name was Imanata. She was 5 months old, and her mother was next to her in her bed, and the mother would watch us all the time as we would tend to Imanata. And you know, you just could feel the feeling the mother had for this child, and she wasn't well enough at all to even pick her head up and to take care of the child. So we would, you know, pick up the child and bring it next to the mother and let her see him. And I knew they were not going to make it. And it was just a question of who would be the first. And that was one of the saddest things we had to do, was to deal with Imanata. And Imanata passed before her mother. So it was just, those are the kind of things you don't forget. You know, there's a lot of attention paid to us expats who come back. Oh, you know, you're the hero. Well, we're not the heroes. The heroes were these guys who show up every day, you know, week after week, you know, for months. I mean, they'd been working, some of them, since June. And I arrived, it was September. All of our staff in some way had been affected. We had one young nurse, and she was caring for four children that her sister, they were her sister's children, and her sister and the husband had both died of Ebola. So she was working in this very, you know, basically high risk area, but yet she was carrying on because she was the sole support now for that family. We had several others who had, you know, relatives who had also died. We had different workers who actually had family members who were patients in our hospital at one time. They're the ones who are the heroes. They're the ones who are there every day and still carrying on. Yes, I would go back. As strange as that sounds, yes, I would go back. You know, I have confidence in MSF and the way our CMCs are set up and the materials and the gear that we use. So I definitely would go back.